is my first video doing a commentary on Euro Truck. So it may be a bit rough around the edges, but we'll give it a go and see how we go. Right, basically today we're doing a quick job. Installed, and the Russian map as well, which has just added a load of extra mileage to try and cover. So yeah, that's the idea between doing these videos, to try and cover as much of it as we can. So I will say, just bear with me with the computer, because it's not the greatest in the world, as you'll see. It does stutter a lot. It's only 3.2 AMD Phenom, so yeah, and it has seen better days. So yeah, so it does stutter a little bit because it gets a bit hot. So even though I've done stuff to try and cool it down a bit, it still gets a bit hot and still stutters. So obviously once the heat gets up, it tends to slow down a little bit. So it might be alright, it depends on where you're going. Going to some of the busiest cities, it tends to slow down quite a bit. But we'll see how we do, we'll see how we do. Right, that noise for the ferry is a mod I've got. I can't remember exactly what it's called now, I'll have a look once we've done this. Actual mods. Right, so I've gone for Berg at the moment. As we go along, I'll try and talk you through some of the mods that I've got on here. I think they work quite well to make the game, I suppose, as realistic as you can get, really, what it is. I use are from Jazzy Cat. I think most people use Jazzy Cat. Yeah, it does a good variety of mods, especially with his AOI packs. So you'll see quite a lot of stuff, which if you use them already, you'll be quite comfortable with anyway. So something that, it's obviously not his real name, or, you know, it's just something that he uses. I think it's RJS. But it's the Big Stover mod. So, as we heard about, you will see loads of Indy Stover parts runs, and you will see a load of Malcolm Logistics. Another one of his ones, a big Malcolm mod. They're a logistics company based in Scotland. And they work quite well with the Jazzy Cat packs. Basically, what they do is they install a load of trailers for like these little bar and Malcolm, and then they match the trucks to the trailers. So say you've got a Tesco trailer, you'll have a Tesco truck on the front, which is quite cool. A bit similar to what Jazzy Cat does with his packs, as you can see there with the trucks where they're matched up with the trailers. It's just why this is so laggy at the moment, because last couple of days I've had this running absolutely superb, and now it's just like a lag fest. So I might have to try verifying the floors from the steam. Let's see if that helps. I don't know if it's an actual issue with the game, or it's just like so, whether it's just the computer, whether it's overheating, it's just slowing it down, so it's probably that morning drink. So yeah, we're off to Malmo. 3 hours and 40 minutes left. Sort of combination. walls for quite a while now, but I've only just this week installed the Russian loop, which is compared with ProMods, it just clips onto the end of it as such. And that works really well, and the scenery on there is just superb, it really is. Do maps and do all the stuff they do. I'm not actually insisting on charge, I think it's superb. The fact that they're constantly keeping it up to date and on top of it and listening to people and, you know, doing what people want in the maps. It's really good. I don't know if you can see there, I've got the camera rotation on, which is an option in the settings. Basically what it does, it just rotates when you steer the wheel. So, you can see there, as you move it to the left, goes to the left a little bit, move it to the right, it goes to the right a little bit. Change it so it goes, you know, when you turn it'll go all the way around like that, but you know, I tend to use it more just for the sort of realistic effects of the physics. It's just sort of steering to the left, it just sort of gives you that sort of simulated view or feeling that you're moving around. Using some traffic packs or some traffic density mods, but they absolutely just killed the frame rates, so I had to sort of knock them on the head for now. And as you can see, the game game's starting off as it is without having any hinder it even more. So once I've done this video, I'm gonna try and see if I can find out why it's just lagging so bad. Yeah, very strange delivery point here, but we'll go with it, we'll go with it. Yeah, I don't know if you can hear that. That's the G27 force feedback. Which is quite good really. Yeah, I mean I don't know why we'd be delivering this sort of trailer to a building site. But yeah, I'm not really one to argue, so easy drop off, which is good. Let's go around here and spin it around and I press that. We are there. Neutral, engine off, disconnect trailer. Right, and that's how I'm done. Nice quick run. Well, I hope you enjoyed the videos, guys. I will be back with the next one. Where we'll be going, I have no idea, but I'll see you then.